Hey y'all, my name is Shan. Welcome to Cozy Room Podcast. This is a series for Black fathers because Black fathers matter. Black fathers matter to me. Black fathers matter to my children. Black fathers matter when it comes to my brothers, my mentors, my friends. They matter because they set the tone for who our children look up to. They set the tone for how men, women, children, and other elderly people feel protected, feel like, you know, everything they've struggled for was for a good cause because they've seen who they've been become. And I want to, I just want to shine a light on them and hear from them in a perspective that sometimes goes unheard because no one cares to ask. Sometimes people look at fathers as if, oh, that's nothing. They're supposed to do that. Why would we, you know, thank you for doing something you're automatically supposed to do? You shouldn't look for any, you know, praise or any thank yous for that. That's standard. That's the basics. You know, do what you're supposed to do. But when you have a father that's there, that's consistent, that's available, that's attentive, that's caring, that's thoughtful, versus an absent father, versus a father that thinks his life and his now is more important than the child's future. There's a difference. There's a clear difference. And I just want to show appreciation. So this series, I've interviewed many, many fathers from different places, different backgrounds. And I really just want to pick their brains with different questions. So thank you for listening to Cozy Boom Podcast, and I hope you enjoy. Recording with T was really funny because before we started recording, he called me. He was like, I'm on my way. I'm just parking the car. I'm just like, all right, cool. Just text me when you're ready. And then he was like, I'm ready now. And then when we got on the Zoom, he still had all his like work stuff. So it's kind of like the epitome of him even before he had kids. Like, when I lived in New York, you know, we was living in the same apartment. And sometimes I would come in and he, like, you know, making his drinks and just doing something to make some more money. And he would work, and even wherever he was working, and he was doing something on the side to go ahead and get some more money all the time. And that's just what he do. So now that he has two kids, it is no like new thing for me to be like, oh, that's T been like that. Like, he's work, you know, make my time for the family. He's married now, so making time for his wife. And it's kind of like, damn, this man done grew up. So T reminds me of my youngest brother. He's like a straight shooter on questions and answers. So we go through a lot of the questions pretty fast because he's not like, oh, I need to think about it. He's like, nah, yeah, this, that. And it's not no hesitation because he's not someone to like sit and marinate on his thoughts. So hope you guys enjoy. Today is actually Father's Day. I had a busy day. I thought I was going to upload it Saturday, but since it's Sunday, here you go. And I hope all the fathers out there enjoy their Father's Day. Peace.
Hey, hey, it's Anya Dula, and I am the host of Intercultured with Anya Dula. Intercultured with Anya Dula is a podcast that focuses on motherhood, culture, birth work and travel. And it's just a place for women to come together to discuss our philosophies on motherhood, to discuss our work and birth work, if that's what we do, but mainly to bring women of all different cultures together so that we can talk about how we mother, how we hashtag do motherhood, so that we can learn from one another and learn to love each other. That's really what it's all about. I hope you'll join us. Intercultured with Anya Dula podcast is available on all the major podcast stations. I hope you'll join us. Can't wait to connect.
Here we go.
Back to the show.
Back to the show.
Cool. I summoned the girl, so I should have quiet.
Nice. I think Anthony has the cell phone and Paige is strapped to a high chair, so.
Man, I feel like you have the best set of kids because you had a boy first, so that already gets your energy in place, and then right behind them you had a girl, so kind of like, you know.
Yeah, I said I wanted it like that, but I don't know if I had anything to do with that.
Man. It's like hit or miss for most people.
Yeah.
So your day was busy?
Yeah. Freaking, my boss is trying to do everything, but with very little bit of people, so.
That's everybody. It's like, do you want to go to work today? Maybe. Do you want to be three people today? No. But that's everybody's work, because a lot of people don't want to go back to work, so.
Yeah, now I was on quarantine. So when we went to quarantine, it was like I'm going from doing like 100 plus hours a week. And you know how I get down, like, and then zero, like dad, like type of shit.
Yeah,
like kept working. So it was just me and the kids, and I was like going crazy. So he called back, yes, ASAP.
I want freedom. I was telling Mike, I was like, man, I started work on Monday and I've had the girls since March up until Monday. Like, they've been with me every day, every night, no matter what, going anywhere I wanted to go. So I'm just like, want a break from them, but at the same time, I don't want to be at work. So,
I feel that. Somebody said to me, it was like that, we're not supposed to be with the kids all the time like that.
Yeah,
like, you're supposed to have some type of break.
Like, your kids are just like people in a relationship or your family. Like, me living with my mom, well, my mom lived with me for like 3 years. I appreciate her being there, but at the same time, it made us like really, like,
yeah.
You know, naggish towards each other. And so now that she lives in Florida and I can reach out to her when I want, she can reach out to me when she wants, and then we can retreat back into our spaces. It's way better. Same thing too. They feel smothered and we feel smothered, and then, you know, it's just better when it's kind of like. But I'm glad you wanted to do episode 14.
Or freaking Mike. Nah, I was gonna, I said, I forgot to call you. I got really busy at work, so.
Yeah, that's fine. What it is just questions. I'm not using any type of videos. Just questions. And you can elaborate if you want. We could come back to the question if you need to. And then that's it. And then if you want, like, add anything at the end, you can. All right.
So this is Cozy Womb Podcast, and this is Black Fathers Matter, episode 14 with T. And you are a father of how many children?
Two. Boy and a girl.
How dare you. And how old are you?
I am 33.
How old do you feel?
It's weird. I feel young. I still feel young.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Probably like 20, 21.
Mm, do you feel like the numbers are changing and you are just here? Because that's how I feel.
Yeah, like I really forgot how old I was for a second.
I think everybody forgets how old they are in their 30s. That's normal. And you were born and raised
in the Bronx.
The Bronx.
I was all over.
Oh man. And right now you think you're New York out. So like you good on New York for right now.
Yeah. I'm definitely over it. I've been over it.
Mm-hmm.
I think I've been over it since I was like 18, to be honest. Mm. That's why I went to ATL.
Yeah.
And it's pretty much just like trying to find my way. Mm-hmm. I know I have more opportunities up here in New York. Yeah. I have the resources and stuff. So
yes.
That's why I was still up there. Mm. And I found my way, then I met my wife.
Yeah.
So I was like, crap.
That's life.
What's
happening? Yep. So we're gonna talk about fatherhood, because this is my view. My view is like parents went from Mr. Solo grind mode, just you know, doing everything that he could do with his time, to okay, since you know he's in a relationship. Okay, Terrence, you know, he has a kid on the way. Okay, he getting married too. Oh, there's another baby too. I'm just like, how did he go from like solo to like real fam moves so quickly? Or is it time is moving really fast? But it's just really like interesting for me to see, because I'm still imagining Terrence at like Gap and Terrence in New York, and you just being grind mode, and then it's like these little people start attaching to you, and you know you're married and you're moving like in family groups. Like how has this transition been for you, going from you to more people of you?
It wasn't really bad. Like it was very easy, because like I wanted kids. I always wanted kids. Like, I always think about my little cousins, and I always like, I mean, like I feel like a kid at heart. I mean, like I'm still like, even now, like my son, we at the park. I'm the only adult on the jungle gym, like running through the park like full speed with my son.
Yeah.
The grind is still there. Like I worked like 100 hours a week, probably. Like I'm still there.
Yeah.
And I'm still at home as well too. Like I don't sleep much. Like,
oh, man.
Like at all. I really don't sleep much at all.
Well, that'll mellow out as I get older. I will say that. But for right now, he's just gonna be busy. What does being a father mean for you?
I feel like I am. How can I say this? I feel like I'm like creating like a friend, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And. Yeah. Part of it too is like maybe like making up a little bit too from like the absence of like my father.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, my kids is dope too, man. Like, I just, I really like, I like, I love my kids. Like, really, like, mm-hmm. really chill.
Yeah. Are their personalities very similar or slightly different?
Definitely different. Mm-hmm. Anthony, it's hard. Paige is only like seven months right now.
Yeah.
Like, it's hard to tell, but. They definitely did different things at this age.
Mm-hmm.
She's like standing up right now, like on her own, like with the, like grabbing the side of the crib and pulling herself up. Like, you know, like,
oh, wait. Anthony
did that. I feel like Anthony, if we still had the crib up, he would still be in the crib.
Does he like to like play with her, or is it like, man, she gets to do baby stuff, I want to do baby stuff?
No, his imagination is like crazy. Like, that's he good. he's all about her. Mm-hmm. And he like, she gives him an attention. Like every time she sees him, she eyes light up. Like, oh,
that's good.
Yeah. So. Like, that's for now. Let's see.
But you know what? You know what I noticed? The second kid is way quicker, way faster as far as like moving and doing things and picking up on stuff because they have like that motivation of the older kid. That's how Aria is. And she picks up on things really well. But now that, you know, Anya's six and Aria's three, I have to get on Anya about everything that she does or she says because Arya's like right behind her on it. And it's kind of like, if I don't do it, I'm going to have two kids with bad habits, or bad manners, instead of one. So that's the battle.
Yeah. I think I'm a little strict. Just a little bit? Yeah.
Are you a first, I said it one time parent, or you give like two more times after that one time?
I'm becoming, I give you more chances.
My God!
I'm definitely annoyed after the first time, especially something that we've gone over before.
Yeah.
But I'm realizing too, it's like some things it's like, it's just not gonna happen. Like,
Do you notice that they go to your wife more for certain things and go to you for certain things?
Yeah, for sure. Definitely. he'll wake up in the morning. My side of the bed is closer to the door. I could be up on my phone. He'll walk around the bed. Like, Kelly would be sleeping.
Yeah.
Ma. Like, and wake her up and ask her for something. Like, I could be like closer to the kitchen and he'll go all the way to the room. Ma, I need something.
Because she's gonna say yes more, it's because he already knows your answer.
Well, all her, every time she responds, it's like, your dad is sitting right there. Like,
oh, man.
You're right there now, so you might as well just.
Well, what you said earlier where you were like, you feel like you're making up for what your dad didn't do. I think everybody does that where even like your mom or your dad, you try to give your kid everything you felt like you needed as a kid. And that might not be the thing that that child needs, but because you missed it, you naturally pour into your kid those things. But that's normal.
Yeah.
The thing is, like, as they get older, like, their personality will show you the the things that they need, and then it gets a lot easier. But for right now, it's just a constant pouring to see like what makes them do the right thing. So just keep doing that. They'll be fine. But he's gonna grow really fast. So just enjoy it. What do you notice about things you might tell your son to do or not to do, and then when he thinks you're not around, seeing him interact with his sister?
Wait, say that again, I'm sorry.
So like when you probably tell him don't do this or do this around his sister, and then he might think that you're not in the room. Do you ever notice him picking up on something he remembered you said, or just like listening wise?
You know, like he's his own person. Like I guess he's been like alone for a while. You know what I mean, like a little sibling and stuff like that.
Yeah.
He's definitely like cool with being by himself.
Mm-hmm.
But
yeah, that's how
I stay with him. He's okay with that.
Yeah.
So a lot of times, if they're like in the same room, he'll be doing his own thing, like in his own, like caught up in his own imagination and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
It's been times he acts like, "Oh, look, let Paige come to my room."
Mm-hmm.
But like she's still baby and he still be getting into some stuff, so I'm not really ready there for that yet.
Yeah.
And she turn one and she get a little tougher, and then, but he's everything. He's a boy. He's a fighting.
Yeah. They're rough a little bit.
I'm like, you can't hurt my baby girl. Like, you can't do that. Right. So, right now, like I'll see him like, "Hi, Paige," and like, but he gets out of that baby stuff like fast. Like, he does it for a little second, but then he gets out of it real quick.
Mm.
Power Rangers it up.
The thing that he's going to probably get frustrated by is if she likes his toys with her toys, because that's how I was with my brother's stuff. Like, I would go in there and be like, "Oh, it's Christmas, you got a train set. Let me see how my dog looks." He's like, "Man, get out of my room." Just like, "Man, let me see." But that's like that boy and girl dynamic. And maybe they'll just be comfortable playing separately. You just never know. At least you don't got two girls that fight over everything. That is madness. That is madness, because both of them are super dramatic.
That's Anthony. He's a dramatic one. Very dramatic.
Like, let me get over that real quick.
He may become an actor. Like
oh.
He's really good at it.
That's Ari. Ari is like the extra. I'm just like, you don't even have to do that. She was like screaming at the top of her lungs tonight because there was a fruit fly on her hand. Just like, "Aria, like, what happened? What happened? There's a fly on me!" I'm just like, "Girl, shut it up." But that's how she feels at it. For you, especially that you work a lot and then you have two kids and then your wife is there and you try to balance your time, what is it that you do to like decompress from everything? And don't say sleep.
Yeah, I don't sleep. Like, I guess you could say I work sometimes.
You can't say you work to decompress when you work so much.
So like, my job is not like a regular, like I work parties.
Mm-hmm.
Like on a, and then it's like during the actual event, some events is you got clients, it's like, "Oh, yo, I need this, I need that." It's a lot of changes and stuff like that. Yeah. But then you have, for the most part, like it's music and I'm like chilling.
So you like, take it as like your time of entertainment sometimes.
I'm chilled at work. Okay. Well, during the party and after the party, I lose my shit.
Oh man. When it comes to like having a team member, your wife, like how important is that for your balance with fatherhood? Like, how important is that for y'all to be, like, on the same page with both of the kids?
Super duper. Like, because, again, like, with my work schedule, it's, like, super tough. Like, I'm gone pretty much, like, most of the weekend. Like, I go in on a Friday. Probably don't see me until Sunday morning. Wow. Yeah. So, but we work everything out pretty well. Like, we definitely adapted to my schedule. Like, crazy. Like, not everybody would do it at all. Like, we're both working on, like, our careers and trying to push forward and stuff like that and move up. Mm-hmm. And she works just as hard as I do. Monday to Friday, but my thing is over the weekend. So I'm there most of the time in the weekend, the weekdays, and she's there on the weekends, and kind of like, yeah, we have like some weekends. It's like a family thing, and then the Sundays.
Because I was like, when do y'all like have y'all chill time? Or is it like when both of the kids are asleep?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, like the weeknights and Sundays and stuff like that.
Okay.
Doing my regular schedule and stuff like that, like I'm off like a lot throughout the week too. Mm-hmm. So I'll have my Mondays and stuff like that, like Tuesdays and
like. Okay. So it kind of works out.
Yeah.
Is your son you see your schedule and her schedule?
Again, man, he doesn't care about like he's in his own world with his stuff, like,
yeah,
he's really chill, really easy kid, like very, very chilled.
What is it about how you used to be as a boy that you see in him?
His temper.
Oh man.
Oh,
well, at least you're experienced in it and you can talk him down.
I'm sorry?
I said, at least you're experienced in it and you can talk him down from it.
No. Nobody was able to talk to me either. Like, Mike, like, said some stuff to me, like, guide me, like, to, like, the right direction as I was a kid, too. But even now, but yeah, it was not much a lot of people could say. Yeah, me and Anthony's like very similar. Like, I see a lot like in myself. Like, he's he wanna be heard.
Yeah.
So like that's one of the big things I had, like, been frustrated growing up and stuff like that. And if you don't pay attention, it gets a little frustrated. Things don't go his way, he gets a little frustrated. Like, he's but he's really smart and just gotta listen to what he's saying. And then, like, yeah, he'll be on point. Mm-hmm. So I think Mike noticed that a lot too. Like, he'll, cause sometimes I'll get caught up doing my own thing and then he could be talking and I'm like, oh crap, I missed like half the shit he said. Like, and then he's like, nah, I know what he's talking about. Like, but he also had experience in that from me, like, growing up.
Yeah.
It was crazy.
Do both of you, like, share feedback with just about your sons and, like, what y'all do as far as, like, what works?
Yeah. But, again, every kid is different, so.
Yeah.
Some things may work and may not work, like.
When I was recording with him, Miles was just on there like singing, and he was like, second, let me get his snare. I'm just like, oh, y'all just into this, okay? Excuse me. But it's funny. It's funny.
If Anthony didn't have his the little phone or whatever, mm-hmm. he would have thought this was his interview.
is he a talker?
Yes.
Oh wow.
Yes. He can't get the stuff out. That again, that's something else too. Like with me, like I'll stutter sometimes, and mm-hmm. same thing. And like you can't get the words out.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if it was a video right before the pandemic hit, and they're talking about how kids is gonna be like trying to like say stuff to you, and the guy is like cooking, go to the shower, go to sleep.
Yeah.
And then. You didn't get it out.
I do that to Anya. Anya would be like, "Mom, and I'm just like, Anya, get it out. Stop talking and just think, and then just get it out." She's like, "You know what? Whatever."
Yeah.
I'll save it. I'm just like, Oh man, it's hard, but it's cool. How do you feel appreciated as a father? Or when do you feel appreciated as a father?
So I have like a spare phone, mm-hmm. and like that's the phone like Anthony rocks out with, like, because he's gonna be on my phone all the time, and like getting upset when you use my phone. So he rocks out with that. It's an Apple phone too, so it has like a free ID. Because on Wi-Fi, he can text and stuff like that. And he'll shoot me texts. He don't know how to spell, like, really. So I feel like sending emojis, telling story. So that's cool. He knows how to do, like, the voice memo. So he'll be on the phone and, like, leave a memo. Like, he actually just left me one for Father's Day, like, happy Father's Day, whatever, like. I like my work, too, like the stuff I'm into, he's kind of, like, into it, too. Mm-hmm. Maybe just because I'm his dad, or if it's really cool, I don't know, but he gets excited when he see that stuff. Mm-hmm. So when I'll FaceTime him, and like, yo, look at this, like, cool setup. It's like, wow. You could do this and you could do that with it, like, good idea, like, yeah, that's cool. Those are cool moments.
That's good, because I think the technology we have now is really set up to change their thinking. So like even like the iPad is to make their thinking a bit faster. We could use it, but it's really to normalize it by the time they get our age, but where it's not a big deal. So,
yeah,
I'm all for like putting kids in technology. I just got Anya a Google Home yesterday.
Nice.
And I tell you, the questions go at Google Home. She'll ask me the weirdest stuff, and I'm just like, girl. She I was watching a movie. She was like, man. She was like, what kind of gun is that when it explodes? I said, Anya, I don't know, because I don't know the names of the gun. But she knows, like, she knows I have guns, but I don't have, like, no guns that have, like, explosions like on movies. She goes in the room, she's like, hey, Google. I was like, but it's good because she can say, like, hey, Google, tell me a story, and it'll, like, automatically go online and pick, like, Hansel and Gretel or Little Red Riding Hood. Come on, I don't have to go in there and do it. Perfection. So I'm loving that thing. She's loving it. She says good morning to it every morning. Like, she's like, this is my friend. I said, girl, cool. Go ahead and have it.
But, so that's definitely me on my like lazy dad day. Like, I need a little rest. Anthony's like, yo, look at this cool thing I just built. I'm like, I'll be in there in a minute. Like, I'm chilling right now.
Yeah.
I was like, but you gotta see it. You gotta see it right now. Yeah, takes the phone, go take a picture, and we can save it for later, but I can see it right now, too.
Yeah.
They're going. Take a picture. He's been, like, vlogging. Like, he's, like, recording himself, like, talk about the structure that he just built with his Legos and, yeah. Like, yeah. So, like, he's, like, vlogging.
That's and, good.
Yeah. It's hilarious because he is, like, signed up with, I have him on YouTube Kids.
I was just about to ask you that. Yeah.
Gosh, he's, like, hours on that thing. And now in his vlogs, he's like, okay, like and subscribe. I'm like, who are you talking to, first of all?
Really?
I'm like, you don't have a
YouTube channel. He has to send me his thing because Anya, she'll go on the TV and there's no Netflix, there's no Disney. I had Disney Plus and she was like, you need to take this off. We don't want this. Just like, okay, we got to take my money. I took it off. They watch YouTube. They talk to the TV. They find the videos. And I don't mind it because that's where she gets like more vocabulary from. That's where she gets more information on how things work from. But at the same time, I always have to like watch what she's watching because some of the kids, even like the parental control, some of the kids' videos, they might have adults talking about gossip and makeup. And I'm just like, why is this on the kids' version? But for the most part, that's all they watch. They watch kids play with other toys. So even with him playing with his Legos, Legos are a no-go in my house because I refuse to step on a Lego, okay? No, that's not happening. So I tell people, do not buy my kids Legos. You could buy them anything else. We could do blocks, but we're not doing Legos. So. But she would watch stuff like that.
We have the larger ones.
Okay.
And the smaller ones, if anyone is on the floor, is definitely garbage. Like, so.
Especially with his sister. You don't want her eating it.
Yeah.
Dylan.
I tell him so many times and he don't listen, so you're going to lose them. Like.
I do a countdown at night. I'll be like, okay, y'all got 30 minutes to the bath. Pick up all the toys. And then once I feel like I'm not hearing enough toys being picked up, all right, after 20 seconds, I'm coming in there with the trash can. I did it one time. After that, she was like, Aria, clean up! She's coming! I was just like, that's right! That's right! Man, that clean up.
Yeah, no, he'll flip it on us. He'll be like, okay, I guess we can throw this away. I won't have any toys. I was like, what? Like, clean the toys up. You still gotta clean it up.
Right. But Anya's been picking out like toys that she doesn't want anymore. I'm just like, did you ask Aria if she wanted it? That's just their thing. What are four things you wish you could improve or change when it comes to what people say or think about Black fatherhood? I'll make it. All right. You need me to ask you again?
I'll change about Black fatherhood. I don't know, like.
It could be stereotypes. It could be things people assume. It could be what you feel like more fathers should do to be an example. Any of those?
I guess I don't. Like, I feel like I'm like selfish. Like I just think about myself. To be honest, like I don't really go that hard with it. Just cause it's like, I don't know.
Nothing?
All right, yo, so like, they're like, yo, Black dads like is not there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Really only experienced that shit with my dad.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of my friends, pops,
mm-hmm.
and they're there.
Yeah.
But they go as hard as I do, like, so I'm not really seeing that. It's not that stereotype is our parents. Like, you mean like,
yeah.
I think for like our generation, Like, it's not, I don't see it now. But like, being the people I hang around and stuff like that, like, I feel like that, yeah, no, that's not even a thing anymore. Like, because everybody realizes that shit's stupid. Like, yeah.
Well, that's the key thing, is the people you hang around are, like, involved. That I always question, like, would I ever be friends with a woman that didn't take care of her kids? And I know she had kids. I couldn't do it, because I'm just like, what conversation do I have for you? So it's kind of like how I think about that. It's like, would you be like, oh, that's my friend, that's my boy, when he don't even got his kids back?
So, yeah. Uh-huh.
But yeah,
can't rock with stuff like that.
Yeah, that's strange to me. But people do it. But that's a good thing that you made a decision to be like, well, that's not what type of father I want to be, so I'm going to do X, Y, and Z. Yeah. A lot of people don't do that. So that's good. You and Mike kind of had the same answer.
Yeah, kids are cool. Like, they like the sponges. Like, and they,
yes,
they learn everything that you can teach them. Mm-hmm. And I, like, if you're teaching them, it says, like, creating my best friend, like, because, like, if you're teaching them something that you're into, they're gonna be new to a certain age, probably, and you could always rock out, like, that, like, I'm gonna take him, like, Anthony's birthday is the 22nd, taking him, and he's, like, so excited, like, oh, I wanna go fishing, like, I never took him.
Yeah.
Like, well, I'm gonna take him, and, like, he see I get excited about it, so he's so excited about it. Mm-hmm. Like,
Do y'all do new things together? Like, if it's something you never tried as a kid, are you doing it with him? So it's both of y'all first time?
I'm kind of like doing a lot of the same things like I've done as a kid. I don't think he's there yet. Like, I mean, like, he's okay. There's gonna be some things that's gonna, we're gonna probably experiment and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. If I'm scared of it, like, I gotta, like, chug it up and, like,
I don't know. Like, I feel like when you're around your kids, and maybe before you had kids, you was like, I'm not doing that. And then you get kids, it's kind of like, well, my kids, they make me feel safer. So I might be in the house by myself, but then once I pick up the girls and they're in the house, I'm just like, okay. Anything that happens, I feel like I have my people with me. Even though they're smaller than me, I feel like I got my people. So when it comes to, like, trying new things, I'm always for it with them. When it comes to, like, doing wild things, like me going skydiving, I didn't feel like it was a big deal, because I'm just like, man, I survived 2 pregnancies and labor. Like, let's go. Like, I didn't feel like there's anything that I couldn't do after I had them, which is, like, wild. But I feel like kids do that for you, where they, you can't tell them, like, oh, you need to try in school, you need to try different things, if you don't try different things. So it kind of, like, forces you to do that. But you go to find out.
Anthony was, like, really scared of, like, he's, like, scared of a lot of things. Like, he won't never climb out the crib. Like, ever. Like, if the crib was still up, he probably won't get out of that. Okay. Like, but this is why, like, I'm in the parks with him, and I'm like, on the jungle gym, and I'm showing him these things, like, and I don't know how, I don't know, I guess, like, he's not growing up, like, around a lot of kids, like, I did.
Okay.
I was impressed. Everybody was like, you know, it's a park right here, like, our parks right now, like, we have to drive to it.
Yeah.
Like, suburban life, I mean, like, so.
I think once he goes around more kids and he sees them, like, doing stuff and jumping from things, I think that'll make him naturally try it. But now, like, he's kind of like in like adult thinking where he's like, well, that don't seem safe, so I'm not trying.
Well, no, like, I'm, you know, I'm in these parks. Like,
but I'm in these parks.
Like, I was telling you, like, I'm jumping off the top of the monkey bar and I'm showing him that I could jump off the top of the monkey bar. I'm like, yo, get some stitches. It's fine. Like, I'm like, yo, by the time I was your age, I had like 4 sets of stitches. Like, you'll be okay.
Oh, man. What's your biggest challenge so far being a father?
Biggest challenge? I guess. So again, like, I don't know. Actually, like, I'm trying to think of biggest challenge. Like, he's like really easy. Like, and I don't want to like.
He's too small to know.
Huh?
You feel like it's too small? She's too small for you to know yet?
Yeah, like, I feel like both of them, like, like, he has, like, Anthony, like, Paige, I don't know, I mean, Paige has given us no issues. Like, like, zero, like, he's just 7 months. Anthony, he eats, like, extra right now, but, like, he eats a lot. He goes to sleep, like, well, just his, like, behavioral issue, and it's, like, again, like, that's him being a kid, like, I get it, I was that person before, so, real challenge, I don't know if I have challenges, like especially, like, being his parent, like, his father, like, I'm really chill, I don't know.
You don't have to have a challenge, so if you don't have a challenge, that's cool. That's
okay.
That's a good thing. I'm not telling you you have to have a challenge, but I don't know. Maybe it's your personality where you're just used to always being on the go, and then just like having kids, it's like you just adapt to their part of this, me being on the go too, and then they'll just mellow out in the scheduling. So if you don't have a challenge, I'm not gonna tell you a challenge is coming, but if you find yourself in one, just know that you'll make it through it. It's just a whole bunch of adjusting.
That's how I like look at everything. Like, yo, it's gonna be okay. Like, if he's like, taking forever to get ready to be, because I'm gonna be late.
Yeah,
I'm just late.
Okay. Like, okay.
Said to tell my boss, I'm like, hey, like, my kid.
Yeah. My, yesterday, I was like, what are some things that you hate? I was like, I don't like being late for nothing. I don't like repeat myself. I don't like cheese on my broccoli. She's like, I don't like cheese on my broccoli. Yeah. I was like, all right. So, like, we have, like, that dialogue for no reason. And I feel like if you're honest about the things that you like and you don't like, your kid makes, like, a conscious decision on if they're going to help with that or go against the grain. So, my thing is, like, just be, like, really honest with them, and you'll see, like, what you gotta deal with. My next question for you is, fill in the blank. Mothers will never understand blank about fathers. What is it?
Mothers will never understand blank about
fathers.
I really like, I don't know, I feel like I really push, like, parenthood and not, like, mother, father type thing. You know what I mean?
One thing.
Yeah, we're both parents.
Okay.
Obviously, yes, I'm a dad, you're the mom. But hold on a second. Hey. At time. Yeah, nah, I pushed here you go now.
Hi.
Yeah, we push like mother and like we push parents and like just so I obviously can't experience everything the mother experience. Right. But after all that part, you know what I mean? Like it's very equal, like in the household.
Okay. Like
they both see mommy working very hard, they both see daddy working very hard, like, and we switch it up, cooking, cleaning, all that stuff, like, so.
Especially that she have a boy and a girl, so they don't feel like a boy is supposed to do this all the time and a girl is supposed to do this all the time. Mm-hmm. It's kind of balanced. Well, like,
I guess, like, that's, like, again, like, my dad wasn't there, so my mom's raised me.
Right.
I'm raised by a female. Like, so, my mom's always told me, like, yo, you gotta learn how to do this. You gotta learn how to cook. You gotta learn how to clean. Like, everything. You gotta take care of yourself because you're not gonna be dependent on a woman.
Mm-hmm.
And so, I saw, like, me and Mike, like, we're, like, hybrids. Like, mm-hmm. So, like, that's how I'm parenting and stuff. Like, I don't know if you've seen any of his videos. Anthony's, like, Chef Anthony videos. Like,
mm-hmm.
Put in and stuff like that. Like, so, pizzas, you do it all.
See, I don't have patience for that yet. And Anya's like, "Can I cook with you?" I'm just like, "No." And all I imagine is like her fingers and things that I have to eat. So I'm just like, "No, you can't be in my kitchen." But my mom will do it with her, and my brother will like let her do stuff in the kitchen. But I don't have the tolerance for that yet. Maybe I'll get there. Since you brought up like the mom and the baby stuff, how were you during like the delivery? Like how was like that for you?
With my job, I am supposed to be cool under pressure.
Mm-hmm.
So like that's like been installed into me just to like be chill. So I feel like I gave like as much of support as I can.
Mm-hmm.
Will allow to take.
Yeah.
And I don't know, like I felt I was calm through everything. I was excited like to like, yo, I only seen this on TV, like
was it very similar? Like, was both of the labors similar, or was one different?
Both was C-sections, and it was so much different. It was different. Mm. Age was a plan.
Yeah.
And went into distress. So.
Okay.
Fast. Age, it was like, yo, we're going tomorrow. Like, we know this is happening. We know everything that's about to happen.
Okay, so you're way calmer and like at ease about it because you already did it.
No, it was more nerve-wracking actually.
Why?
I don't know. It's like the anticipation. Like, it's like, yo, we know that we gotta do this, so why are we not doing that right now? Like, okay. What's up?
Okay.
And, but then like the first time around, like, the adrenaline was, like, pumping. Because it was, like, we don't know what the hell is happening.
Yeah.
Like, so, but, like, I was more calm in that situation because I was, like,
mm-hmm.
And then I knew, I didn't know what was going to happen. So, like, I was more cool-headed.
Okay.
But knowing that I know that we gotta go through this. This is the next step.
Yeah.
What is taking so long? Like, it didn't take this long the last time.
Okay, like, you're anxious.
Yeah.
Okay.
So,
well, that's good that they both, you know, went through that, and mom is healthy, the kids are healthy. I just feel like they're equally, both of you put together, and they look like, this is what both of you look like as a girl, this is what both of you look like as a boy. I'm just like, how did they come out like this? It's like so fascinating to see like the second kid come out so like similar, but so different at the same time.
Twins.
Yeah.
They look like twins.
Yeah.
Amazing.
That's cool.
But they say me and Mike were like too. I don't know. Yeah.
Mike and you are like slightly different, but y'all are really close to where y'all don't have to really say much, but it's understood. And I think that's where y'all get like, oh, they just like one, but not really. So I get that. My last question for you is, what advice would you have for a younger or new father? When it comes to fatherhood,
kids are dope. Just like speak to them as you don't baby them. Mm-hmm. Like that's not like how they're gonna move forward. Like and like just speak to them, and they're gonna listen. And like they're gonna take everything in. And surprise the crap out of you.
Yeah. I think that's when I get really excited, is like seeing everything I taught them just like come out like so easy. Like they knew it the whole time. So like it's like inside I'm just like, it's like a checkmate. But yeah, that's a cool thing. Well, I feel like it's very exciting to see you, Father. Because you've always been good with kids, and to see you married and just making your family work is really like exciting. And I'm just like, okay, I know a friend that's doing fatherhood in the right way. To me, I feel like that's the right way, because you make it work and you make it like a normal thing, and we need more examples of that being normal. So, thank you for doing that. Happy Father's Day.
Thank you.
I hope you're not working on Father's Day.
No. I stopped doing that a long time ago.
Thank you.
Thank you guys for supporting Cozy Womb Podcast. My name is Shan. When you listen, you support. And I just want you guys to know that I am thankful and I'm grateful. And when you listen, you support myself, you support my daughters. When you buy anything from Cozy Womb Shop, you support. And I appreciate it. You could have picked any podcast and you're here. Please visit us on Cozy Womb on Facebook, Cozy Womb Pod on IG, Cozy Womb Pod on Twitter. I would love to hear from you. And I hope you guys have another teachable day, another productive day, and you just keep things in motion. I know things feel very weird right now with this quarantine going on, but we can do it. Peace. Bye.
Bye.